Good morning, everybody. It's been a couple weeks since I've done an update, so we went through a period of quite a lot of rain. There was a lot of cleanup, and there wasn't really anything to show you, but yesterday I just spent quite a lot of time out here, and things are looking a little bit different. So before I show you what looks different, I'm going to show you what came out, and then you can see what is new. So you know something significant had to happen when you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 cans and 3 bags. So let's see where this all came from. Okay, so you remember when I did that video a couple weeks ago and we were talking about our garden, but then we were talking about our Yarden, which was that frightening area that we are gonna work on this summer. But when you come through the actual garden, now all of a sudden you should be able to see some more light. So you walk through here, and all that stuff that you saw just now came out of this entire area right here. This is the mystery citrus that we don't know what it is. And I had to stake it because I came out here a couple days ago and see all these vines. Those need to come out still, but they were overtaking this entire area. There was a little unwanted invader tree there that came out. It wasn't really a tree, it was more like a huge shrub that was just taken over with vines. And then this was actually leaning to the ground, so I uncovered it, staked it back up, because we don't know what this citrus is going to be, but we want to take care of it while it's growing. And so yeah, quite a lot gone now. And when you come through here, this is going to stay, this prickly palm, so it's going to be kind of the divider. Look at those thorns in that sucker. It's like, oh, you look over the top, that's going to be a little area that we're going to make into a sitting area patio. But we don't want this to go all the way through there. So this is what's left, which is still pretty significant. I mean, Kirsten got rid of a lot of this the other week, but when you look now, it's this portion that's left and this portion that's cleaned up. And hopefully a couple more good hours spent out here, or a couple, I should say, maybe 2 or 3 more days of a couple sets of good hours will help clean that up. But it just looks so much better. And you can actually see light through there, which you could not before, which will help this tree. So while I have you out here, let's take a look at what's blooming. So remember we talked about how much rain we had. Well, this poor thing, I don't think it's going to recover. However, one of the other vincas came back, which I'm really happy about. The passion vine is now climbing, which I'm super happy about. And a lot of other things. The firebush is blooming. The pentas are blooming. Milkweed is always really wonderful this time of year. We're really looking forward to this bird of paradise whenever it blooms. Got some new banana palms coming in, which is cool. Quarterweed looks fantastic. All the vincas, so pretty. And who can resist the gorgeous sunflowers? But the thing that we're really excited about is that we planted this Alamanda last year, and this is just, I mean, the blooms on this, they're just incredible. And I have a sunflower kind of woven into there. It's just so pretty. just so very pretty. Let's go back around. I know I need a stabilizer thingy when I walk, so I do apologize. That is something I'm going to get in the near future, so I apologize for that. And the pentas here with the Buddha. So nice. Lizards are everywhere. They're like, what are you doing? The lizards have a tendency to follow me around because when I tear stuff up, inevitably there's some bugs and they get breakfast. Our fountain's not quite sunny enough to get that going. But yeah, things are really filling in. Lantana. These caladiums that we thought were totally gone are now coming back from last year, which I was so excited about. And just everything looks nice. I'm gonna plant another cosmos here. It's hard to tell, but I'm gonna plant the one from upstairs. And the dahlia, look how good the dahlia is looking now. It loved all that rain. Pineapples. It's just a great time of year for the plants. One, two, and three pineapples. The desert rose is still putting off a lot of blooms. The fact that this was like, God, 3 years or so with nothing. So exciting to see blooms. Now let's take a walk upstairs. Everything pretty much looks like normal. Got a couple more okra to come off. I've been picking them every single day. This box of okra is doing really well. Remember when we planted that about a month and a half ago? The tomatoes that I scaled down are now starting to have new little tomatoes again. It's like the tomato bush that could. This is exciting. So remember the Jake Mace okra that we planted together just last week or the week before? Here, let me do this. It's already coming. That's the tomato plant that planted itself. Oh, we got some cosmos blooming. Those are gonna go into the garden today, and that's going into the garden today. All the papaya are good. Marigolds are growing. Broccoli, you know, the outer leaves are still getting a little weird, but the inner portion of the broccoli isn't bad. So we're gonna keep that going. And that's really about it for this week. You know, it's so hot. It's so very hot outside. So, and the mosquitoes are terrible. So you can only spend a little while out here and you have to cover up or you have to put, we have a guest coming. Hello, how are you? He's like, where's my food? Where's my food? As I was saying, you either have to cover up completely or spray bug repellent on you, which I absolutely cannot stand. So just kind of doing it at a maintenance level right now, but I wanted to show you the new stuff that was going on. And I hope you all are having a good week. Sorry, this one was a little boring, but hopefully I'll be back next week with some more exciting stuff. He's back. What you doing? What are you doing? You my little buddy? Are you my little buddy? Oh, you my little buddy. He says, where's my peanuts? One little add-on, I did plant some of the amaranth that was in Jake Mace's seed bank. So we'll see. I've never grown anything like that. We'll see how it goes. All right, have a great day.